In the past week, doctors around the world began sharing reports of smell and taste loss in patients with confirmed cases of COVID-19. Several groups of ear, nose, and throat specialists have suggested that these could be coronavirus symptoms and so could serve as an early sign of infection. But as of yet, neither smell nor taste loss have been systematically studied in large groups of patients with COVID-19. We can't say exactly how smell loss relates to COVID-19, but until scientists know more, you should exercise self-isolation if you think you're losing your sense of taste or smell. If further research reveals that the symptoms are common and linked to a person's overall prognosis, the precautionary measure could help doctors identify and isolate potential COVID-19 cases without patients making a risky trip to the hospital. Complete loss of smell and taste are closely related ailments associated with a wide variety of conditions and diseases. Early data suggests that COVID-19 may also induce symptoms. For instance, a survey of 59 people in Italy found that 34% reported at least one smell or taste disorder, and 19% had lost both. A similar survey of 100 patients at University Hospital in Bonn, Germany, found that about two-thirds of the patients noted smell or taste loss that lasted for several days. And a survey of about 2,000 patients with mild COVID-19 infection in South Korea reported that about 300 patients, or 15%, showed some degree of smell loss. As more and more data pours in, scientists need to determine when the symptoms emerge in most people, how severe they are through time, and if and when they dissipate. There are three potential explanations on how a virus might affect smell. In one scenario, SARS-CoV-2 could infect the inner lining of the nasal cavity, triggering localized inflammation. Alternatively, the virus might specifically target cells in the nose that react to incoming odors. Receptors on these cells serve as docking stations for smelly chemicals, which once bonded to the receptor, jumpstart a chemical and electrical reaction that passes information onto the brain. If the cells bearing smell receptors become infected and can't generate signals, a person could temporarily lose their sense of smell. Thankfully, because these sensor cells are often damaged by chemicals and pathogens, the body replaces them every 30 to 60 days. Beyond infecting nerve tissue in the nasal cavity, the virus could theoretically infiltrate the olfactory bulb, the brain region where cells in the nose send smell information to be processed. A 2008 study of the SARS-CoV virus, which caused an outbreak of severe acute respiratory syndrome in 2002 and 2003, revealed that the coronavirus could penetrate the olfactory bulbs of transgenic mice. From there, SARS-CoV went on to infect deeper structures in the mouse brains, causing extensive damage. Several review papers have suggested that SARS-CoV-2 may do the same in humans and potentially infect regions of the brain that support breathing and heart rate. If this is true, some of the purely respiratory symptoms of COVID-19 might actually be defects in respiration controlled by the nervous system. But again, these hypotheses have yet to be supported with hard data. Aside from official scientific tests like the University of Pennsylvania Smell Identification Test, or UPSIT, people can test their sense of smell using the so-called jelly bean test. When you chew a jelly bean, taste receptors on your tongue pick up the sweetness of sugar or the sourness of citric acid. Chemicals from the jelly beans also travel to the back of your throat and up into your nasal cavity, where they interact with smell receptors. Your brain sticks these tastes and smell sensations together to identify the flavor of the food, so if you plug your nose and chew a jelly bean, its specific flavor disappears, leaving only sweetness or sourness. Of course, until scientists clarify the link between smell, taste, and COVID-19, the utility of these tests remains speculative.